हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल गुरुमंत्र शिक्षा का ग्रंथ। आई एम योर एजुकेटर निधि दुआ एंड आई वार्मली वेलकम्स यू एट दिस प्लेटफॉर्म। सो गाइज, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड, यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन एंड योर स्टडीज आर गोइंग इन अ स्मूथ मैनर। सो गाइज, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री, वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट स्ट्रक्चरल आइसोमेरिज्म and this is our second part of isomerism in which we are going to study about stereoisomerism. Okay, so this is our syllabus that we have covered till now, and without any further delay let's begin our today's topic, that is stereoisomerism. What is stereoisomerism? In stereochemistry, stereoisomerism or spatial arrangement or spatial isomerism is a form of isomerism in which molecules have the same molecular formula and the sequence of bonded atom but differs in the three-dimensional orientation of the atoms in the space. Okay, or simple language you can say stereoisomers have the same molecular formula and same structure but they differs in the configuration. What is configuration? That is in the arrangement of their atoms in the space. Okay, now we have the geometrical isomerism. In this type of isomerism, the compounds possessing same molecular formula but they differs in the property due to the difference in their geometry. In geometrical isomerism, the isomers, the compounds, the structures possesses difference in their geometry. That is due to the difference in the direction of attachment of same carbon or group in their molecule. For example, as you can see here, we have two structures. One is for malic acid and another one is for fumaric acid. When C double bond OH group is attached to right side, the direction of attachment of this group is from right side, then this is your malic acid. While in this case, when the attachment is from left side, the structures becomes fumaric acid. Okay, so in geometrical isomerism, we will talk about the direction of attachment of the same carbon atom, or you can say same atom or group in their molecule. Okay, now the conditions for GI. What are the conditions that favors the geometrical isomerism? First condition is there should be a double bond in the molecule. Okay, this is very important condition, that there should be a double bond in the molecule. Second condition is the two atoms or group attached to the each doubly bonded carbon atom should be different. If one of the two doubly bonded carbon atoms carries two identical groups, then the molecule does not exhibit geometrical isomerism. As you can see here in this example, C double bond C. Number one condition is fulfilled, that is there should be a double bond in the molecule. There is double bond present. Okay, second condition says with each carbon atom there should be two different groups attached. Now as you can see here, in number one carbon atom, one atom that is attached is hydrogen and another one is also hydrogen. Therefore there will be no GI, no geometrical isomerism. Okay, also in this case, as you can see, number one condition is fulfilled, that is double bond is present, but the second condition is not fulfilled by this structure. Why? For carbon one atom, the two similar kinds of groups of atoms are attached, that is CH3. That's why there will be absence of geometrical isomerism, or you can say no geometrical isomerism will be there. Now examples, number one example is your alkene. In case of these two types of alkene, there will be geometrical isomerism. Why? Because in both cases, substituent on carbon 1 and carbon 2 are different, hence they will show geometrical isomers. Second example is your cycloalkanes. Why? GI is also possible in these cyclic compounds. As you can see here, this is your cyclic compound, a closed structure in which geometrical isomerism is present. Okay, why geometrical isomerism is present in both these structures? Because from a single carbon atom, two different groups are attached. Here hydrogen, here CH3. Here CH3, here H. Okay, now what is transform and cis form? When the two similar kinds of atoms are attached in a similar plane, then this will be your cis form. As you can see here, CH3 in both the cases, CH3 are attached to the upper side and hydrogen are attached to the lower side. While in trans form, both CH3 attachment are in opposite direction. Okay. Now, as you can see here, in this type of cyclic compound, there will be absence of geometrical isomerism. Why? Because two similar kinds of atoms are attached to the one carbon atom. Okay. Next example is for oximes and azo compounds. When you talk about oximes, the oximes are formed by the reaction of carbonyl compounds. Okay. Now, what are carbonyl compounds? The compounds which have C double bond O type of atoms, that can be aldehyde and ketone. And when the aldehyde and ketone, these carbonyl compounds attached with, reacted with NH2OH, that is hydroxyl amine, then they will form the oximes. Okay, as you can see here, this reaction, C double bond NOH plus H2O. If this carbonyl compound is your aldehyde, then the oxime that will be formed is known as aldoxime. While if the carbonyl compound is your ketone, then the oxime that will be formed is your ketoxime. Okay. For example, this is your aldoxime. C double bond NOH attached to RH. This is your aldoxime. While when two alkyl groups are attached with a carbon, then this is your ketoxime. Okay. Now, if you talk about in oximes, in aldoximes, synoximes and antioximes are found. Now, what is synoxime and antioxime? In synoxime, the position of OH group, the attachment of OH group is from right side. While in anti form, in case of particular aldoxime, the attachment of OH group is from left side. The first member of aldoxime does not show any GI. What is the meaning of this? First member of aldoxime means the value of R is the alkyl group should be CH3. If in case of aldoxime the R group is your CH3, then this type of aldoxines will not show any geometrical isomerism. Okay, this is very important point. Next is in ketoxemes. When you talk about in ketoxeme, the structure is like this. This compound is syn for ethyl group and for anti for methyl group. When the OH group is from attached from right side, then this compound is syn for ethyl group. Okay, and anti for methyl group. Similarly, when OH attachment is from left side, then this group is anti for ethyl group and syn for methyl group. Now, second is in azo compounds. What are azo compounds? The compounds that are formed by the reaction of nitrogen double bond nitrogen. Means in azo compounds, you have two nitrogen atoms bonded by double bonded nitrogen atoms, in which you have anti form and syn forms. What are anti form and syn forms? Anti forms means for one nitrogen, the another group of atoms attached are from opposite direction. Means as you can see here, in this nitrogen, the C6H5 group is attached from upper side, while in this nitrogen, C6H5 group is attached from lower side. Similarly, in this case, both the nitrogen has C6H5 group attached from the lower side. That's mean if the attachment of side is similar, then same, then this will be your syn form. If the attachment of the side atoms are from opposite side, then this will be your anti form. Okay. Now, the EZ system for geometrical isomerism. This is very important topic, guys. I would like to tell you that we will study the theory part for EZ system in this lecture, and we will cover up the questions related to this system in the next lecture. Okay. Now, let's concentrate on what is EZ system. Okay. So, the stereochemistry of highly substituted alkene cannot be defined as a cis or trans. For this purpose, a new notation is known, that is EZ system. Okay, or you can say EZ configuration or the EZ convention is the IUPAC preferred method of describing the absolute stereochemistry of double bonds in organic chemistry. It is an extension of cis or trans isomer notation that can be used to describe double bonds having 2, 3 or 4 substituents. Okay. Now, let's study about the rules related to the EZ system for geometrical isomerism. Okay, guys. Number one rule is the higher the atomic number of the atom bonded, attached, bonded directly to the stereo center, then higher is the priority of the substituent. Okay, this is your rule number one. Second rule is, if two identical atoms are attached, then the relative priority of the group is decided by a similar comparison of the next atom in the group moving away from the stereo center. Okay, these are the two rules for naming the EZ system. Now, this is very important priority order for EZ system. You have to remember this priority order. This will help you to solve the questions related to EZ system. Okay, guys. I repeat, guys, we will discuss the questions related to EZ system in next video lecture. Okay. Now, in case if you are new here at our YouTube channel, you can like, share and subscribe. If you have any query, you can mail us on tanejanehaofficial@gmail.com or you can contact us on the given number. Now, a very important announcement. If you are preparing for CSIR UGC NET, you can follow Neha Taneja ma'am on Unacademy platform. On Unacademy platform, you will get daily live classes, structural courses, live tests and quizzes, and with one subscription, you will get unlimited access. If you are interested in this course, you can go through with this detailed paid classes. While taking these detailed paid classes, you can use referral code Neha, that is NEHA. And after using this referral code, you will get 10% discount on total fee. Thank you very much, guys. I hope you all like the video.